There we go. I can hear you now perfectly. If you can go ahead and ask Sergey how he's feeling in preparation for fighting Jaron Ennis.
I just did. He said everything was fine. The camp went just well. Great sparring partners. A lot of work. And he's ready to roll next week.
Tell us about the fact that people have anointed Jaron Ennis as being the future of 147. And from the outside looking in, it would appear as if this could be the fight to take Ennis to the next level. How does Sergey respond to that thought process, the fact that Sergey might be used as a stepping stone? That's what some are believing.
Как я к этому отношусь? Больше тренируюсь, я более мотивирован, вкладываюсь по полной на все 200%. А парень действительно очень хороший боксер, высокий, большой, быстрый, сильный. Поэтому бой будет очень тяжелый. Мы настраиваемся на все 13 раундов тяжелой войны в ринге, поэтому отличный молодой боец. И я тоже выкладываюсь, делаю все, чтобы победить.
Well, if anything, it motivates me and makes me go harder in the gym and push myself into the level where I wasn't pushed before, probably. The kid is really, really, good fighter, and he's got a size, he's got power, fast, good reflexes, and that's why we're getting ready for, for a war, and that war is going to be as long as it's going to be. Whatever it's going to take, we'll be ready for it.
How much has Sergey grown under the guidance of legendary trainer Joe Goosen?
Ну, Джо Гузен старая школа, показывает ближний бой, средний, ближней дистанции, и оттачивает то, что у тебя уже есть, а не у меня есть. Мне очень нравится, мы проводим какие-то тяжелые тренировки, которые я никогда не видел, и только слышал и смеялся над тем, что там 50 раундов нужно бить мешок. Только сейчас почувствовал это на себе, и мне на самом деле нравится тяжелая работа с Джо.
Well, Joe Goosen is an old school trainer, and he will teach you real well to be close quarters and mid range. He'll make you do things that you never done before, and that's what I really like about it. Some things that I watched Joe doing in a ring before in the gym, when I wasn't even training with Joe yet, I was laughing, I couldn't understand why. And now that I'm training with Joe for a while now, and he makes me do that same thing, sometimes just like 50 rounds on the floor, different bags, different motions, and now I understand what is this all about, why he's making me do it, and I love it. Stylistically, this is my guy.
And Alex, what do you see from Sergey with Joe and the evolution of Lipinets?
Well, I kind of second what he just said. Joe, stylistically, is a really tight fit for guys like Sergey. Sergey's an aggressive guy. He wants to come to where he's comfortable throwing combinations and be more powerful, and that's what Joe teaches you to do, And once he teaches you how to get on the inside and be effective in there, not just to stay there and don't know what to do. And that's what he taught Sergey to do, And like I said, I've known Joe for 30 years now. I've had different fighters train with Joe, and stylistically, I had some guys that came off the Olympic Games, classical boxers, and they could not handle, being with Joe. They just couldn't, and just never fit. It's a hard work. Not too many people, and not too many fighters that I've had personally could hang it with Joe. I'm telling you, it's a tough work in the gym. So yeah, I like it, and I like the fact that him and Joe became like best buddies.
Yeah, it almost seems like it's a perfect fit from Sergey's style compared to the way that Joe tries to teach and train
like
his fighters.
Like a glove. Like a glove. Yep. Absolutely.
So does Sergey feel like his pressure and his ability to step on the gas is going to affect Jaron Ennis, who probably has never been in there against someone of the caliber of Sergey Lipinets?
No, это произойдет на любого эффект, потому что тяжело, когда тебя давят, постоянно прессуют, бьют. Мы постараемся сделать это, где-то боксировать, где-то давить. В общем, у нас есть пару планов на бой, которые мы отрабатываем, и все, что-то пойдет не так, нужно будет поменять, мы все поменяем и сделаем, как будем стараться все сделать для победы.
Well, it could affect anyone. You know, when someone comes at you and keeps on coming and throwing punches from different angles, it will affect anyone. I mean, I don't care what caliber the guy is, and I don't care who he was in the ring with. It does affect. And, you know, but it's not the only aspect of the game that we're going to bring in. We got a couple of different game plans that we're going to implement once it needs to. And, of course, it's like I said, it's going to be a tough fight.
The last fight Sergey had was against Castillo Clayton. That was a draw. What did Sergey feel in regards to that decision? Did he feel like he was robbed in the fight against Castillo Clayton?
Ну, в бою я чувствовал, что я выигрываю. И после боя еще раз пересматривал пару раз бои с командой и один и с тренером. Ну, по моим подсчетам, я выиграл 8-4 из 12 раундов. Ну, чуть-чуть отдадим должное Клейтону, 7-5. Вот. Но это на самом деле был, конечно, близкий бой. Я давил, попадал больше. Поэтому я думаю, что я выиграл.
Well, even during the fight, I thought that I was winning. I was up ahead. And after the fight, we sit down with the team, with Joe, and watch that fight over and over again. We counted 8-5.
7-5, you mean.
I'm sorry, 7-5, 8-4. Being, like I said, being generous and modest, you know, 7-4 is fine. But I was the aggressor in the fight. I threw more punches. He was pot-shotting. I'm not gonna, you know, bring up the fact that my left, you know, I pulled my hamstring in the third round or fourth, and it did deprive me of some movements that I was supposed to make, and I became a little bit better target for Clayton. But like I said, whoever understands boxing, watch it again, and you will see that the first seven rounds, it was my, those are my rounds, hands down. And look, people just don't expect me to look the way I looked with Clayton. And that gave them an opportunity to count it the way they count. People expect me to come and be decisive and either hurt people or knock people out. But it didn't happen in that fight. For whatever reason, I'm not going to talk about it, but it is what it is. But I believe that I won.
Now, was part of that reason the fact that he was supposed to fight Abdukakarov and the date got moved once or twice? And, you know, I've heard two different schools of thoughts, that peaking is a thing and then sometimes that peaking isn't a thing. You know, because of the change of date, because of the change in opponent, very different stylistically, did that affect Sergey in his last performance?
Well, I can answer that because I was in the camp with him. Listen, he was in the camp for 8 months with Joe Goosen. That's a tough camp.
Yeah, that's a long, that's a crazy long.
That's what I'm saying. Getting ready for Abdukakarov first. Then they call in, they said, okay, you know what? You're going to have to start getting ready for Van Herden. He's a southpaw, so we start getting ready for Van Herden. And then they said, no, Abdukakarov is coming back. He's going to make it. So get
Who are you guys getting ready for? Sorry to cut you off, Alex, but who are you guys getting ready for?
Chris Van Herden.
Okay, Van Herden. Okay.
Right. And, you know, they were giving us different names throughout this whole time. And then they would bring Abdul Kakorov back over and over again, saying, no, he's going to make it. He's about to get his visa. It's all good. Get ready for Abdul Kakorov. So they were switching us back to forth in about, I say, 2 weeks. That, and I'm being really generous right now. Two weeks before the fight, I got a phone call from TGB. They're saying, listen, you got to re-sign a contract because you're fighting Clayton.
Wow.
So that was not. And if you're asking me, is that going to affect a fighter to get ready for one guy and then get ready for another guy and stay in the camp for that long? I believe it is. I mean, I believe it's a big hurdle to get someone in the top position, you know, conditioning wise, in a top, you know, condition to be in a camp that long and don't know who to train for. So that it is going to affect, but it's not the case. Sergey was ready. Sergey was ready in Clayton's fight. He was ready. The hamstring. And the fact that, it just...
Well, Clayton's difficult. I mean, Clayton was a difficult guy to deal with.
And again, like I said, Clayton is not, he's not the guy that you can walk through. That's number one. If you look at Clayton's fights prior to Sergey's fight, you will see that Clayton was fighting aggressively, coming forward, hurting people, knocking people out. But Sergey, he was running. I mean, literally running. Look at the fight again. Literally running. It almost became a stinker at some point because he didn't want to get engaged. Why is that? Is that because he had a better plan? That was the way to. You thought he was going to beat Sergey? I don't think so. I think that, you know, he got hurt and he said, you know what? I'm not going to take my chances. And a smart move. I'm not saying. Yep. That's the way I was in the corner with Sergey, so I saw the whole thing, and it's all good. Like I said, he did what he did.
Well, now with Sergey, he's the underdog heading into this fight against Jaron Ennis. Is that something that he pays attention to? Is it something that he uses as motivation, or is it just business as usual?
Конечно же мотивирует, но в любом случае я выйду и буду боксировать как обычно, как умею, и мы здесь готовим, всегда Джо тренирует чему-то новому, показывает что-то новое, и обязательно, я думаю, выстрелит это в бою.
Well, it does motivate him, and but it, I mean, he's still going to be same Sergey Lipinets. He's still going to come and put out his best in the ring, and he's still going to do what he normally does. It doesn't matter if he's an underdog or not. I mean, he's been an underdog his whole life. You know, whoever ever believed that Sergey Lipinets would be a champion of the world, in a 13th fight. I mean, he doesn't have that Olympic pedigree. He's not one of those guys that came and was silver spoon fat guy that was given some right music to fight. No, if you look at his record, you will see that. He fought guys that nobody else would fight, you know. That's the deal. And he doesn't care. He really doesn't care. That ticks him off in the fact, you know, motivates him. He wants to prove something different. But it's a game of chess. That's all there is to it.
Does he feel the fact that Sergey has been a world champion before? Ennis is on, you know, he's climbing up the ranks. But does Sergey feel the fact that he's been in world title fights before? He has a very good amount of experience that will play a factor in the fight on April 10th against Jaron Ennis on Showtime Championship Boxing.
Возможно, но мы не ставим ставку на это. Мы ставим ставку, что он будет драться все 12 раундов тяжелый, что получится тяжелый, изнурительный бой. Поэтому мы готовимся к 15-раундовому бою. Мы спаррингуем очень много работаем на мешках. Я бегаю с ускорениями. И думаю, что бой получится на заглядение, получится, потому что Энис любит тоже не бегать по рингу, а встать в средней дистанции и драться. И у нас ну, получится зрелищный бой, который нравится фанатам бокса.
Well, you know, it's a simple thing that, yeah, he might, but we're not gonna, you know, put our money on it. We don't care. You know, he could be ready. He could not be ready. That's on him and his team. But they know what they're expecting. They know what's coming. They know how to deal with the situation that they're dealing with right now. I'm sure that they're professionals. The bottom line is, he's the guy that will fight you. He won't, you know, he won't run. He won't be, you know, trying to be cute. He will. It's a Philly guy that will bite in and stay in the trenches and fight you. And that's what's going to make it a good fight. That's what's going to make it a very a fight that everybody's going to watch and talk about after the fact.
April 10th, Sergey. How's it going down on Showtime Championship Boxing against Jaron Ennis? How does he see the fight playing out?
Это будет отличный зрелищный бой, так что не пропустите. Вживую на Showtime, смотрите нас с Эннисом. Всем фанатам бокса и моих фанатов всем большое спасибо.
Well, it's going to be a very, very good fight. That's all he can say. It's going to be a fight to watch, and he really appreciates everyone that supports him. And the ones that don't support him, they also still going to, you know, tune in and watch Ennis to do his thing. And that's all there is to it. Just tune in. Showtime, April 10th.
Sergey, Alex, thank you guys very much. Alex, really appreciate you translating. You're fantastic,
you
as always. Sergey, thank you very much. Good luck. We'll see you guys next week in Connecticut.
Thank you.